The man credited for piecing together key elements in the famed Boston Strangler investigation has died.
I never knew my grandfather, Detective Phil DiNatale, because he died when I was 5. But everything I do know about him, I learned from his homemade detective archive. Kept as a family heirloom since his death in 87, there are boxes filled with newspaper clippings, day-to-day journals, home movies, and hours of audio recordings by Phil.
So the reason why I want to become a police officer is that my father was a detective in the Boston Police Department for 38 years.
Phil would go to any extreme to crack a case, making pinches all over his beat in the Back Bay. He was the type of guy to document his every move, with each and every arrest report filed away in sealed envelopes. But there was one envelope Phil never got to seal. From 1962 to 1964, 13 women were strangled in the greater Boston area by a man known as the Boston Strangler. For 3 fearful years, there was not one clue until my grandfather got a hold of the name Albert DeSalvo.
Albert is a cool, cold, cold, cunning person.
And checking him and everything else started to fall into place.
But Phil never sealed the envelope on DeSalvo. The case he was most famous for has never been officially solved. So why was my grandfather still being interviewed 20 years after the investigation? What story did he have to tell?
This is the untold story of the Boston Strangler, Philip J. DiNatale. But that's what upsets me, and that's what gives me a cancer. And I've had it ever since.
Phil knew this case was like a disease. And now, 3 generations later, his archive and investigative legacy still has a stranglehold on my family.